8 years old. I was 8 years old. to this day. Yeah, my team don't fight everybody. Yeah, oh, nigga, I'm old.
Sixth highest murder rate in the U.S. for 2020. The rise of NBA Youngboy shined a light on the daily life and street politics of the city. The Youngboy is the only popular rapper from Baton Rouge, and another hot artist was sworn out of the NBA camp, maybe threatening Youngboy's title as the most popular rapper from the area. Here's a look at the most deadly beef between NBA Youngboy and Fredo Bay. To fully understand this beef, let's take a look back at the beginnings of Youngboy's career and a beef he had with another Baton Rouge artist named G Money. Youngboy is known to rep 38th Street on the north side of Baton Rouge, which is where the title of his breakout hit 38 Baby comes from. But early in his career, he will link up with the crew from South Baton Rouge called TBG. South Baton Rouge is divided into two sections: TBG, where Top Boy Gorillas claim the top section, and BBG, where Bottom Boy Gorillas claim the lower section. Today, the NBA camp is cool with BBG, and both have beef with TBG, but that wasn't always the case. Growing up, Youngboy was friends with the younger brother of a rapper from TBG named G Money. G Money was a few years older than them, and became a mentor to Youngboy. When Youngboy started to rap, G Money brought him into the TBG collective, started helping him make music. The rapper can even be seen in the video for the TBG track, iPhone 6, along with G Money and Fredo Bang, who was also a member of the group. iPhone 6 blew up and made G Money one of the biggest artists coming out of Baton Rouge at the time. Youngboy also released his project, Life Before Fame, while signed to TBG, but it failed to gain much attention. G Money became the focus of the label, and Youngboy was pushed to the side. Right around that time, Fredo Bang got locked up for attempted murder. When he went to jail, everything was still cool between the TBG and NBA crew. By the time he was released, it was an all-out war. Youngboy eventually left TBG because he felt like he wasn't getting the shine and attention he deserved. He instead began to focus on himself and building the NBA as its own brand. This is where tension started to build the TBG camp, and the relationship would only get worse after a few key events. First, Youngboy started getting close to his cousin Bruzilla. He and Bruzilla had been beefing while he was part of TBG, but they eventually made up and began rocking with each other again. Bruzilla was a member of BBG and had issues with TBG, which would eventually lead to his death. Around this time, Youngboy was starting to build a buzz of his own and began using his new platform to go shade his former friends. On the track 4-1, he raps about where the beef with G Money began, saying, "Remember smoking weed with your little brother? Matter of fact, nigga, I used to call you my big brother. Then you did some foul shit and had sex with my sister. Then threw it in my face in front of the people on Insta. You Money later admitted in an interview with Say Cheese that he did sleep with Youngboy's sister, which was the start of the beef. He said that it happened a long time ago. Youngboy wasn't tripping over at first. But after he started getting attention, success got to his head and let his emotions get the best of him. The two continued trading diss songs over the next few months and quickly went from subliminals to calling each other out by name and making it clear that despite their past affiliations, they were no longer cool. While this was all going down, Youngboy's cousin Boozilla was shot and killed in Baton Rouge. Immediately after he was killed, Youngboy went out looking for who was responsible and ended up catching two attempted murder charges. He and three of his affiliates, NBA Ben 10, NBA Self-Paid, NBA Joe, slid to the ops block and let off a few shots at the two people they thought were responsible. They ended up missing their target, but NBA Joe was somehow shot in the neck and brought to the hospital. A suspect named Trash One Coates was later arrested for the murder. It's not clear what the motive was, but the gossip on the internet is that it has to do with Boozilla dissing a TBG rapper named Dusa. Boozilla's murder only added fuel to the fire and the beef between the NBA and TBG, but it was put on hold for a while Youngboy was locked up. Youngboy was arrested for attempted murder and spent the next 8 months fighting the case. Even though he was potentially facing life in prison, his lawyers were able to plead it down to just a 10-year suspended sentence. Check out our video on rappers that beat a murder charge for more info on this case. After Youngboy was released from prison, the beef between him and G-Money got even more heated. Youngboy dropped his album, AI Youngboy, which featured several disses aimed at his rival. He and Youngboy started going back and forth on social media, dissing each other and making threats. D-Money then dropped the track, Industry. Youngboy never broke again in response. He takes direct shots at Youngboy. Tragically, in September 2017, D-Money was shot to death in the parking lot of a music studio. He's about to link up with Fredo Bang, who was said to be released from prison that same day. He was killed before Fredo got out. G-Money was killed and kept Fredo locked up for a few more months out of fear that he may retaliate and end up getting himself killed. This is where the beef between Fredo and Youngboy really began because he was locked up while all the other drama was going down. The NBA camp had the advantage at that point, with TBG's main artist dead and its other two most prominent rappers, Fredo Bang and Boulevard Quick, behind bars. But it just so happened that Boulevard Quick and Youngboy's brother, OG33, were both in the same prison dorm. In an Instagram live session the rapper did after getting released, he claimed that he jumped OG33 in jail to get revenge for G-Money's death. Youngboy cooled off with the diss tracks after that because he had no one else in the streets to beef with, and he was a suspect in G-Money's murder. But the beef would pick right back up again after Youngboy's manager, Desmond Hartnett, also known as Dump, was shot and killed outside of his home. So it seemed like only a matter of time before another body was dropped from his bloody war gone way too far. Beef may be put on pause for a while after Youngboy was arrested by the FBI in March 2021. Back in September, he was charged with illegal weapons possession and the distribution and manufacturing of drugs. He and a group of other men were filming a music video outside an abandoned trap house in Baton Rouge. The neighbors were being used as an excuse to get him off the streets and end the deadly cycle that has been raging in the streets of Baton Rouge. That's because it and a canine unit was deployed to locate him. Youngboy was denied bond in this case and is being held until his trial. A California judge initially approved a $540,000 bond, but this was later denied by a Louisiana judge, who had the final say because the crime occurred in Baton Rouge. The court claimed that Youngboy was a danger to the community because of his past crimes and his history of ignoring the conditions of his probation. So it seems like the feds aren't playing around with this one and are looking to make an example out of Youngboy to try to put a stop to the violence going on in Baton Rouge. Although Youngboy has a history of beating difficult cases, this one is looking very different. It seems like the feds have identified the NBA crew as a violent street gang, and they are looking to pay Youngboy the sole leader of the operation. If Youngboy ends up doing some serious time, it'll be a major L for the entire NBA camp. TBG will have the upper hand in the music industry, and Fredo Bang still doing his thing. Hopefully, Youngboy will beat the case and learn his lesson. With so many lives already lost, it seems like the beef will just continue, even if Youngboy is behind bars. If you like this video, we have many more on our channel. Rappers killed by friends, and rappers who ran from the cops. We cover the most insane stories that you need to hear. Also, be sure to check out our second channel. We'll be uploading there just as much as we do here. Click the link in our description and subscribe if you're gang gang. Well, that's all for today. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and give us a thumbs up. Let us know in the comments what you'd like to see in the future. Put yourself family, knowledgeable, money-saving records.
I'm going to go to the next one. Thank you. appreciate that too.
Thank you.